Hello everyone, welcome to the first training webinar for the i2b2 tranSMART Foundation. We have a full program this year that's coming together. You can see the different classes that we've got lined up already on the website, and I welcome to register for any of these that you're interested in. As usual, all of the sessions are recorded, and these are made available on our website along with the slide deck and also on our YouTube channel. As you can see, we've covering topics that include tranSMART and i2b2. Later in the year, we'll start having classes on the i2b2 tranSMART program that is being developed in Paul VX Lab at Harvard Medical School. But today, we're delighted to welcome Yulia Skopin to present for us from Rancho Biosciences on using tranSMART. Yulia, let me turn it over to you.
Okay, thank you.
And you should be able to take control of the screen.
Okay. Can you see my screen?
Yes, looks good.
Hello, everyone. My name is Yulia Skopin, and I'm from Rancho Biosciences. So today we'll talk about how to get your data in tranSMART. So I'll be the presenter, and most of materials were prepared by Monica Coelho. So if you have any questions, please contact us. Here's the emails, and also you can contact i2b2 tranSMART Foundation. So today's agenda is I will show you demo how to load the data set in tranSMART. So we talk about TM data loader, the ETL tool that we're using to load data sets. We go through data curation guidelines, clinical data and high dimensional data, gene expression, for example. And these properties belongs to analyze tab. So we also mention how to load metadata for studies in browse tab, and also how to attach or upload files in tranSMART also using browse tab. So in this slide deck that will be available on i2b2 tranSMART Foundation website, you will also see data curation example that you can access after this seminar. So let's go to demonstration first. So I'm going to use Rancho Biosciences tranSMART instance. So right now it's open in Analyze tab. And for those who is new, please use Mozilla Firefox or Chrome browser to use tranSMART. So I'm going to load a data set under test studies over here. And we'll show how study will look after loading, and then we also delete it. So in order to load study in tranSMART, I'm going to use WinSCP. And this is a useful tool to get your data sets into tranSMART server. So I'm going to use our credentials to get to the instance. Entering password. Another one. So right now I can see folder directories in my local directory and in tranSMART directory. So these are data sets and files and folders right now at the tranSMART instance. So this is TM data loader folder. And if you go inside, we will see ETL related folders and files. And we have here TM ETL jar file. So if I go back and go to tranSMART ETL data, you can see that I have folder structure here that reflects the position of the studies at the tranSMART instance. So I'm going to use test studies folder, and load studies into under test studies. So first I need to transfer data set from my local directory into desired directory at the server. So as you can see, you already see a couple folders here, but they have these kind of prefixes before. So the prefixes done or disabled or failed would prevent study from upload. So right now these studies will not be uploaded. So the data set I'm transferring under test studies contains both clinical and microarray data. That's why it's a little bit heavy. Let's take a look what's inside. So as you can see, under study name asthma TITSO GC31773, there are two folders, clinical data and expression data. Clinical data contains two files. One is in both in TXT format, and one is basically clinical data, and second one is a mapping file. In a few minutes, we'll take a look how these files should be organized and formatted to be properly loaded. And second folder is expression data. One file is a data file. Another file is subject sample mapping file and platform file. Okay, so once we transferred the data set, we need to start to open PuTTY terminal and run a few commands. So I'm connected. So I need to go to the directory where my study is. So my study is in tranSMART ETL data. So in tranSMART ETL data, I'm going to test studies. So we can see that two studies have prefixes done and disabled. They will not be loaded. And asthma TITSO GC31773 is not protected from loading, and it should be loaded when I execute loading commands. So basically, to load commands, to load study in tranSMART, it's sufficient to know two basic commands. So one command is just Java jar, and you need to show with the position of TM-ETL jar file on the server. Or you can use more extended version of this command with no hub when you have a very big study and you don't need to be connected to the server all the time. And the process of loading will be executed then on the background. So right now I'm going to use this command. And as you can see, the ETL process has started. And it's interactive mode. And therefore, you see all the information that's going on. So we can see that loader right now processing mRNA data. And after this will be done, it will start loading clinical data. And clinical data is very short for this study, and the process should not take too much time for that. So depending on the size of data set, loading can take a few seconds, several minutes, or even several hours. So this really depends on the type of data, on the size of data, and probably it's also depends on your server properties. So while when data is loading, let's go back to the internet resources that you can use for additional information. So first visit i2b2 tranSMART Foundation website. You can find information about tranSMART Foundation trainings, recordings, previous classes, previous years trainings. They're also useful. And it is very useful that you can find curated data sets that already formatted for tranSMART and can be easily loaded. So you can look at the formats of these data sets and use them as a templates. So also I would recommend to visit tranSMART Foundation wiki page. And I have links to that in my presentation. And it's also available at the tranSMART Foundation website. And you can see what kind of ETL tools are available for users. So there is a tranSMART batch, TM Data Loader, and our focus today is TM Data Loader ETL tool. You can also use Kettle. It's a like oldest tool for loading in tranSMART. Some users prefer to use ICE data loader. And there is also tranSMART data loader. So, but again, we talk today about tranSMART TM data loader. So if you go to this page, you will see very useful and helpful information, everything about curation of clinical data, gene expression data, all kinds of data supported by tranSMART. And you will see not only instructions how to do that, you will see commands, exact syntaxes that should be used when you name folders, files, and what kind of formattings should be inside the files. And you will also find working examples, samples, mapping files, and so on. So it says that procedure is completed. Let's take a look at the tranSMART instance. So you can see that study is loaded in tranSMART now. Let's check if everything is loaded as expected. So it's very important once you load the data set to test it if high dimensional data is loaded properly. So basically you running any of tests in advanced workflow tests using high dimensional data. Okay, so the next command we're going to run will be delete study. So, and most useful option is to delete study by ID. When you know study ID, and you should know study ID because it's always shown in the files curated in the curated data set as in the study ID column, and it also will be appeared in the grid view when you drag and drop this data set on the grid view. Just in a moment. So high dimensional data is loaded properly. And now let's go to grid view. And under trial, you can always see study ID. So let's go back and use another command to delete the study. Study deletion may also take from several seconds to a few minutes, depending on the size and data type that we have. So for this small geo data set, this would take less than 1 minute. So it says that procedure completed successfully. Let's refresh the page and look if study was deleted. Yes, study is deleted. So let's take a look what happened in the study folder. So I'm going to refresh this page. And as you can see, we had ASMAT CITSO GC31773B4. And now we see this prefix done. It was done automatically by ETL tool. So if we go inside, we can see done and done. That means that both clinical data and expression data were loaded properly and without any mistakes. So let's go back to general information. Are there any questions at this point?
This is Rudy. If you have a question, you can raise your hand, or you can type a question in the question window, or put something in the chat window. And I'm watching to see if anybody has any. I don't see anything right now. Okay.
Okay. So this is the link where you can find the information about TM Data Loader that I just used. So this TM Data Loader is a very flexible ETL tool. It supports flexible data mapping options to utilize multiple linked data values. This ETL tool allows advanced mapping to keep source file, means your clinical data, with minimal changes. So you would not need to split file into smaller files or pivot data. It saves time and assures data integrity. So this ETL tool uses some syntaxes like data label, visit name, and also tags. They are very helpful to properly map your data for tranSMART. So how to prepare data for upload? So data and mapping files should be arranged in a folder structure named as study name, study ID. So this is study name, study ID. So clinical data can be named clinical data or clinical data to upload, how you see on this screenshot. And expression data should be named expression data or expression data to upload, as you can see. Under each folder, you can see the mapping file and data file. There could be several data files that should be reflected in mapping file. So expression data should contain data file with data with the data matrix, subject sample mapping file, and a platform file. Each study must be placed in nested folders in ETL directory according to desired study path. So you can design study path whatever you wish. For example, tranSMART ETL data, then public studies, name one, name two, name three if you want. So on the wiki page that I just showed you, there are few more options how you can run, how you can start ETL process. So there is a basic commands, and you can use different available options like interactive mode and other modes. You can use delete study by ID that we just did, or you can delete study by path. There is also a command for that. You can move study. You can move study, for example, from public studies into private studies. And ETL tool will process all files in ETL directory except folders with following prefixes: disabled, done, or fail. After processing is completed, the study folders and subfolders will be renamed with prefixes done if upload is successful, and fail is if upload was failed. So you can use different options: interactive mode, check duplicates, no rename, and so on. So this is some additional information you should keep in mind, and basically you can use it if you use it on a regular basis. How to run ETL tool. So install FTP SFTP client. For example, WinSCP is an open source SFTP client. Connect to the server. Transfer files into appropriate directory. And this is a tranSMART ETL data directory. Open party session. And run commands from the directory that you put your files, and use the commands. As I said, you can use basic command, or you can, if you need to be disconnected from the server, you can use no hub version of this command. You can always see what where your process is using using command tail and showing number of lines you wish to see. So when you start ETL process, you can see this black screen from party terminal. And basically, if it's interactive mode, you can see what's going on. So what kind of data is processing, and ETL file first reads and checks all the files. And if something wrong with the files or formatting is not correct, immediately will, on this first stage, the ETL give you the information about mistakes or errors. So the second part of interactive mode, when data is loading, is running stored procedures. So you can see run procedures i2b2 load clinical data, set data label to null, and so on. Check the duplicates column, and so on. As I said, if something goes wrong and the format is not valid and something is missing, the ETL tool immediately will give you error. And you can read the log and find what is wrong with the files. And where to find this mistake actually is also helpful. So now we go to data curation guidelines. So, for example, if we need to load any clinical data set in tranSMART, and we will use as an example a geo data set, we need to get all the information for the data set to be able to imagine and to see the structure of that study that we want to have in tranSMART. So for that, we need to get all the information about the study, all the data pieces put together, and then put this information in organized way. So tranSMART is a subject-centric platform. So all data will be subject-level data. And it's very convenient for physicians and tranSMART users because it's easy to split data into cohorts by subject IDs or by any other characteristic. The small helix shortcut, it's a high dimensional data. Green shortcut is a categorical data, and a blue numbers shortcut is a numerical data. Variables are identified by full path name, like folder, subfolder, node name. For example, for the data set we loaded, we have a full path name for the information about sex, is a test studies, study name, subjects, demographics, sex, and the value for the categorical value. Combination of subject ID and full path needs to be unique. Otherwise, tranSMART will consider this information as a duplicates, and you will have to remove any duplicates values from the data set to be able to load the study. Clinical data in tranSMART, any numerical or categorical text values will be automatically classified by ETL tool. The clinical data is not high dimensional data, and each data value links to unique subject ID. Clinical data requires controlled variables. Study ID is required.
Looks like Yulia dropped offline for some reason. Okay, the webinar is still running, but Yulia got knocked offline. Let me try to see if she realizes it. I think she's coming back.
Hello.
Yep, there you go.
Yeah, sorry about that. Something with connection.
Yeah, okay.
So we were talking about controlled variables. So study ID and subject ID are required variables, and they have some sort of requirements. They should be capitalized, and subject ID has to be no longer than 21 characters. So visit name and data label are optional variables. So control terminology for summary statistics. So if you have variables like age, sex, and race, they should be named exactly as it is. Do not name sex as gender, because otherwise tranSMART will not recognize this column and will not put it in the appropriate place. So clinical data curation, step one. So as I said, you need to get all the information about the data set first. So you need to read associated publications about that and get all valuable information. For example, on the GEO website, you will get the platform annotation file if it's standard platform. You get series matrix file, which contain a little bit of clinical data and usually normalized data for gene expression. So once you download series matrix file, it will look like this. So this header part is not important and valuable for curation, but the lower part is usually clinical data, and even lower part you will see it's normalized expression data. So if you transpose this clinical data part, you will basically can bring this data to that standard standard view that will be useful for tranSMART. So study ID should be a mandatory column, subject ID, any other information available. This will be all clinical, categorical or numerical data. So the step, next step would be transformation of the source file into tranSMART clinical data file. So as I said, we need to apply controlled variables and terminology. And we also have to keep in mind on some restrictions. So table format contains study ID column, unique data row per combination of subject ID, visit name, data label is required. And now a stack option is also available. It's actually possible to adjust table size columns manually. Special characters may be changed during ETL. Like for example, sign a percent will be changed by ETL into PCT, and plus sign will be changed for and so on. So backslash will be removed and Greek symbols will not be uploaded. So keep in mind if you have these characters or symbols in the data files and how they can change, can be changed after uploading. So use preferred and consistent terminology if you have several data sets that you need to load at the in the same place at the same instance. All files should be saved as a tab delimited text files. So how clinical data will be displayed in tranSMART? So here is the example of the mapping file on the one side and study tree in tranSMART on another side. So you can see subjects, demographics, age. So in the mapping file, we created folder subjects, demographics, and data label called age. In the end result, in the tree, study tree, we can see created folders subjects, demographics, and the value age. So the clinical data model has five columns: file name, category CD, column number, data label, and fifth column is optional called data label source. So first column shows file name of clinical data file, and multiple files are allowed. Category CD creates a path to display data. So the plus sign means that we create a new folder. And there should not be any spaces in between any words in this category otherwise the path will be abrupted in the place of space. So here is data label column shows variable name or controlled variables. When we put omit, the ETL tool will omit information in these columns in the data file. Data label source is used when you also using when you use advanced mapping, and it's needed when you use data labels in the mapping. It's optional. There are a few more rules how you can put visits and data labels, how you can interchange them. And this is some information you can also find at wiki page. So let's go to see some examples how data is mapped. And this is an example of extremely complex mapping. So in this mapping, we used data labels, visits, and tag. Here is the example. This is a study with a whole cascade of folders. You can see clinical data, endpoints, several endpoints, baseline, days, and even time. And here is the example of clinical data type. So study ID, subject ID, first visit, view, I mean, the visits by baseline or maintenance, next visits are by days, next visits are by time, and so on. So, and the value of everything is in the column G or a column 7, and these are value for response. So here is the screenshot for mapping file. So we should put file name, category CD. So we're creating clinical data, endpoints. Then if we put data label, and data label is column F, this will be enumeration of endpoints. And if we introduce tag, and the tag is a column E, tag one is a column C, it's a baseline on maintenance. Visit name column 4, it's a visits in days. Another tag is visits, shows visits in hours. So and the last one is the data value, and we put backslash and number of data label column. So backslash and number of data label. So this is kind of very complex structure, and my advice is to use more simple study tree to be more user-friendly, but sometimes it's impossible to make it simple, and in this case we have to use this complex mapping. So here's another case of less complex mapping but using a data label. So here is the example of clinical data file, and the desired way how we want to present data in tranSMART. Clinical data, clinical endpoints, test X with units, and the values underneath. So on this fragment of mapping file, you should put clinical data, clinical endpoints, test X in, with units, plus data label. Data label should be in column 3, and basically this is a data label and visit. And again, backslash for the values, and we should indicate the column where data label is, and this is a column 3. So a few more advanced options and even merge options are available on wiki page. Just briefly, I can mention that you can replace clinical data in tranSMART, you can update clinical data, and you can even append new variables for clinical data. So this is all possible, and please check the instructions how to do that. So now we'll go through gene expression data. So gene expression data is a high dimensional data, and in tranSMART, it's a matrix with normalized gene expression values. And this is how gene expression data file should look like. So you can see the first column called IDREF, and then underneath probe IDs. And then to the right, you can see sample IDs. So gene expression data should be properly named. A file should be saved as study ID, gene expression data. Then you put special letter here, TXT format. So what are these letters at the end? So you put R, L, or Z. R is used for normalized data. So we normally used only normalized data in tranSMART. L is used for log2 transform normalized data. And Z is used for Z-score normalized data. So there is some discussion what is appropriate, what is better to load in tranSMART. So you can go here to get more information about that. But the bottom line, you can both load normalized data as is, or log2 transform normalized data in tranSMART. So we cannot load raw cell files in tranSMART and so on, but this information can be used, can be added in tranSMART as an attachments in browse tab. So next file that belongs to gene expression data is called data gene expression data mapping file. So the first column is a study ID, then site ID column is optional, subject ID and sample ID. This block shows how sample ID map to subject ID. The second block is a platform, so you put gene expression platform here. Third block is a tissue and attributes. These are sample annotations like tissue, sample, time point, and so on. And the last part of this mapping is a category CD. How to display gene expression high dimensional node? So you put here the folder's name you wish your high dimensional data will appear underneath. So the file should be saved as study ID, subject sample mapping file, also TXT format. So here is the example. So this is the how the created category CD path will look in tranSMART. Biomarker data, platform, and it's interesting that platform will not appear as GPL 96. It will appear as a full a platform name because tranSMART is connected to the internet and will get this information about full platform name. And then breast tumor, for example, if tissue type is tumor. So if you populate attribute 1 and attribute 2, they will also appear underneath here, and breast tumor will be a folder. And only last attribute will be having this helix shortcut. Okay. And the last file that is needed for gene expression data upload is a data platform file. So probe ID in the platform file should be mapped to entries gene. Platform data is uploaded only once in tranSMART. Platform data file should contain ID, it's required, it's a probe ID, same as probe ID in a gene expression data file, gene symbol, And other columns are also important. So regarding platform name, for Geo, tranSMART will fetch the name directly from Geo. For other platform, you need to insert information into tranSMART. So on wiki page, you can also find how to insert information for custom platform. So there is some format for that, and also examples of any custom platform that you can use for tranSMART. So this is an example of platform file, how it look in the website. It will have this header, and it's not needed for the tranSMART loading. And the column headers line, they have all required columns for data loading. So if you directly downloaded file from Geo, you just need to remove the this header, and this file is good to go for loading. But if you creating this file from scratch, platform file, you need to be aware of the mandatory ones in the formats that are. Okay, so what kind of high-dimensional data in similar as gene expression data upload, you need to have a data files and properly name subject sample mapping file and have a platform file. Study metadata and upload files. Are there any questions at this point?
I don't see any questions yet, but anyone has any, raise your hand or, yep.
So we're going to our last part of our presentation is discussion of browse page. So I'm going to go back to the tranSMART instance. So okay, so I'm going to browse tab in tranSMART. So, and browse tab is needed to have all data related, all metadata related to this study. Okay, so if you logged with admin credentials, you can use this button and click add new program, and it will show you a menu that you need to populate to create a new program. For example, new program is CNS diseases or oncology or respiratory diseases and so on. You put description for that program. You add program, target, pathway, phenotype, and therapeutic domain. You click save, and the new program will appear in your on your browser page. So, for example, we can see here that under the program CNS diseases, we have one study, Huntington disease, GC78272. So you can add new study You can add new folder. You can delete the program. So there are like very user-friendly options here. You can edit associated text. Let's click on Huntington disease shortcut. The shortcut of the study is connected to analyze tab, and the study is loaded in analyze tab. If you look at this browse tab, is a metadata that not subject specific but associated with study that would help user to find all information about the study. Browse. And what is interesting and very useful is that any internet is a little bit slow, but I will try to refresh the page. And go back. So the menu has a button called upload files, and it will show you immediately this kind of window when you can either drag and drop files into that blue area, or click on this blue area and it will open in this as attachments under the study. So this will be available. This is a tranSMART website. You can find curation data sets and information about previous and future trainings and tutorials. And these are some more links that will help you to get information about curation for tranSMART. Thank you very much and have a great day.
Okay, thank you, Yulia. If there are any questions, we can take one more or two. Otherwise, I think we'll wrap it up. And as I say, the recording will be available within a day or two, hopefully. And the slide deck will also be posted. Thanks again.
Thank you. Bye.
Thanks, Kuya.